Microorganisms or microbes such as bacteria, viruses, fungi, algae and protozoa are found around us in soil, air, water, on our bodies and even inside our bodies. But are they also in places where we might not survive? Such as the hot springs where temperatures are as high as 950 degrees Celsius, the deep oceans where there is no oxygen, the icy lands around the Earth's poles, or high above the Earth's atmosphere.
Dr. Shivaji, the Center for Cellular and Molecular Biology and his team set out on a journey to explore the microbial world. They looked for microbes in the most extremes of the climates. The early expeditions were to some of the coldest places on Earth's poles, Antarctica and Arctic Circle. They carried with them sample collection bags, food used for growing common microbes, sterile dishes to grow these on, an incubator to maintain an optimum temperature for microbes to grow, a simple microscope to look at the microbes, and a refrigerator to store the samples. They dug and collected ice, soil, and water samples from various depths of Earth. They put some of the samples on the microbial food in the dishes they carried with them and grew some of the microbes. But they didn't have enough food and dishes to check all their samples. Also, they didn't have the right food for all the kinds of microbes these samples contained. So, they brought the samples to the Center for Cellular and Molecular Biology and further investigated them there. The scientists tried these samples on different microbial growth media and waited for days. After about 2 weeks, they saw bacteria growing on some of the media. Unlike our cells, these bacteria had quite a few superpowers. Most of these could grow on simple nutrients like glucose as carbon source and proteins as nitrogen source. They grew well at freezing temperatures. They also found bacteria that formed spores to escape unfavorable conditions. They found these bacteria were resistant against UV radiation. They also observed bacteria in Antarctica are more colored than other commonly found bacteria. The pigmentation and cell membrane composition of these bacteria probably protect them against UV and freezing temperatures. Their next quest was to look for presence of microbes in the sky, 20 to 40 kilometers above the Earth's surface. This region is called the stratosphere. Here, air is thin, and we humans cannot breathe on our own. The scientists use hot air balloons to trap air in the stratosphere into sterile stainless tubes. They brought these tubes with air samples to the Center for Cellular and Molecular Biology. They identified fungal and bacterial species, some of them even new ones that were also UV resistant. They continued their explorations in the depths of the oceans and the glaciers in the mighty Himalayas to look for newer microbes with unique characteristics. Many scientists in India also followed suit. Each newly discovered microbe from these extreme weather conditions is a treasure house of special properties. Maybe one day, the UV-resistant properties can be used for making sunscreens and microbial pigments as food colors. This is in addition to the hundreds of microbes we use in food and drinks, pharmaceutical and biotech industries. And who knows what more unique microbes with interesting and useful properties we can find as we discover the millions of hidden microbes. They're all waiting for explorers like you. Are you ready to start your explorations in the microbial world? Presented to you by CSIR CCMB, CSIR Jigyasa, supported by Department of Science and Technology and National Council for Science and Technology Communication. To know more about CSIR CCMB's work, please visit www.ccmb.res.in.